The president has a new proclamation. Hi, I'm Jim Hacking, immigration lawyer practicing law throughout the United States out of our office here in St. Louis, Missouri. Shooting this video on June 23rd, 2020. Yesterday, President Trump expanded an earlier presidential proclamation 10014, and it is a doozy. It was an expansion of a ban on certain immigrant visas, and now he's expanded it to non-immigrant visas. And I'm going to go through the new proclamation. It hasn't been numbered yet, but it's the proclamation dated June 22nd, 2020, and it's called the Proclamation Suspending Entry of Aliens Who Present a Risk to the U.S. Labor Market Following the Coronavirus Outbreak. And I just want to go through it with you piece by piece, share my thoughts. We are not doing this on our regular background or editing schedule. We just want to get this out as fast as possible. So we want you to have the information that you need because we know that this is going to cause a lot of questions. So the proclamation begins with a recitation of sort of the severity of the coronavirus and talking about the unemployment that has resulted as a result of the global pandemic and specifically in the United States. The president reminds us that he had issued Proclamation 10014 on April 22nd, 2020, and suspended for 60 days many categories of alien immigrants. That is, he was not allowing immigrant visas for many categories of people. Really, the only people that were excluded were those working in the medical field or the spouses or underage children of U.S. citizens. Everybody else, when it comes to immigrant visas, were banned from the United States for those 60 days. He has now extended that ban to December 31st, 2020. And of course, with all of his bans, there is a caveat that these might be extended. So again, if you don't know that this November election is very important, you sure as heck know it now, because he's trying to stop legal immigration to the United States and he's using the coronavirus to do that. So as of right now, with this issuance of the second presidential proclamation on the issue of immigrant visas, the following categories of people are not eligible to get green cards to the United States, even though federal law says that they can. So first would be the parents of U.S. citizens. So parents of U.S. citizens are immediate relatives under the INA, and they are excluded from being able to come to the United States to get their immigrant visas. The spouses and children of green card holders, the brothers and sisters of U.S. citizens, the employment-based green cards are all still excluded. Diversity visa holders are excluded. And now with this proclamation going through until December 31st, 2020, the president has all but killed diversity visa lottery winners from coming to the United States. And now with the proclamation yesterday, it has also extended that to H-1B visa holders and L visa holders, and other categories. We're going to go through all those. But for now, the first thing that you have to know about the proclamation is that it's an extension of the prior green card / immigrant visa ban. And no, this does not apply to people in the United States who are trying to adjust status, but this does apply to people in those categories who are seeking immigrant visas and are at the embassy ready to come. They are now not able to come to the United States. So, and they won't be able to come until the end of 2020, the last day of 2020. So the president talks about a page and a half about all the economic problems caused by the pandemic, and then he gets to the proclamation. So he continues Proclamation 10014, and he says that it'll be terminated on December 31st, 2020. And that shall become effective immediately. So, Section 2, suspension and limitation on entry. The entry into the United States of any alien seeking entry pursuant to any of the following non-immigrant visas is hereby suspended and limited, subject to Section 3 of the proclamation. So, any H-1B or H-2B visa holders, or any alien accompanying or following a joint, so that would be like H-4 visa holders, a J visa, to the extent the alien is participating in internships, trainees, teachers, camp counseling, au pairs, or summer work travel programs. So this would be everybody coming on the J-1 exchange visa, where they're coming to work for employers, like in hotels, or for training, and where they're actually working as a nanny or an au pair. Those are all banned. And then L visa holders. So those are intercompany transfers. These are people that work for overseas wings of big companies. These have all been banned from getting visas into the United States. And it applies to people who are outside the United States as of yesterday, June 22nd, 2020, that don't already have a non-immigrant visa that is valid on the date of the proclamation and doesn't have an official travel document. It does not apply to lawful permanent residents, aliens or aliens who are the spouses or children, underage children of U.S. citizens, aliens who are coming to help with the food supply chain, or any that would be allowed in under the national interest. So there's a national interest exemption. But for the most part, it's going to ban all these people. And so the proclamation directs consular officials to figure out if people are trying to get visas in these categories. So again, this does not apply to people who are in the United States. So remember, visas are your ticket into the United States. So this proclamation is very much a stretch of the presidential power, but it is all based on this idea that the president can exclude certain categories or classes of people. And that's sort of the basis of this power that he has. Now, as many of you know, we tried challenging that as it related to the diversity visa holders and the parents and adult spouses of green card holders. And we did not succeed, but we anticipate there's going to be more litigation over this. And in fact, we might be litigating some of it ourselves. The proclamation directs the Secretary of Health and Human Services and CDC and the Secretary of State and Homeland Security for doing inquiries into how they can make the country safer when it comes to people bringing diseases, which is interesting because the prior proclamation didn't say anything about diseases, and the president's just throwing stuff in there to make immigrants sound more dangerous. It goes into effect tomorrow. June 24th, 2020, I think I might have said that it went into effect yesterday. I think actually it's sort of inconsistent internally as to when it starts. It says the proclamation shall expire on December 31st, 2020 and may be continued as necessary. And then it directs the Secretaries of Homeland Security, State, and Labor to recommend any modifications to this. And that's all just ways to cover it and to try to make it look legitimate. So all of this piece of crap proclamation is in conflict with the Immigration and Nationality Act. It should all be challenged. The president has, just with the stroke of a pen, apparently killed off the diversity visa program, which is something that he's always wanted to do. Because if you have a diversity visa, if you get selected in the lottery, and this selection would have happened a long time ago, if you're ready to come, you have to get that visa by September 30th, 2020. And now that the ban goes all the way till December 31st, it looks like those people are now outright banned. Now, that might give us an angle to work with in court now that the president has taken that action. So we'll see what happens. But for now, this is the proclamation. I wanted to get this video out to you as quickly as possible. So we're just going to upload it in this raw form. I think Mackenzie might put my name on it and stuff, just so you know how to contact us. But if you have questions about the new proclamation, you can email us at info@hackinglawpractice.com. We're probably not going to be able to respond to each and every email just because there's so much interest in this proclamation, and that's why we made the video, to sort of walk you through our thoughts on it. Obviously, we think it's bad and it's contrary to the INA and it should be struck down, and we'll see what happens with that. You can always call us at 314-961-8200. I already gave you our email address. You know, we have Immigrant Home, where we're going to post this video and other immigration news. And make sure that you subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you get updates whenever we make videos just like this one. Sorry for the informality with the dress and the proclamation itself, but I wanted to make sure I got the information out to you as quickly as possible. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.